Hey, what's going on, everybody? Welcome back to The Edit Place, and today is going to be a pretty easy one, but still pretty visually interesting, especially if you're trying to work on upgrading that maybe demo reel, colorist reel, creating some social media content. So we're going to show you how to create this. Now, as it goes for pretty much any tutorial out there, there's usually a handful of ways to do everything. So this by no means is the only way to do it. It's just the easiest, I think. I've seen plugins, templates, and all that good stuff. But to me, this is something that's super easy, and pretty much any of the major NLE editors have the crop tool, and that is the one tool that we're gonna use today. So let's jump into it. So in here, you can see I have my final shot. For those curious, this was shot on the Blackmagic Pocket 6K. We can see this is the final look, and this is with the whole gray turned off. And you can see all my nodes here. There's the raw image. And then we bring in a simple utility LUT, get some primaries to fix exposure, add a creative LUT, a little bit of skin softening for beauty, a vignette, and add some contrast back into skin. Now, of course, every image requires a different grade and a different amount of nodes or layers. So you may have three. In this case, I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So I have 8. I did not count that properly. I have 7. I have 7 nodes. And in this case, we're going to head back to the edit page here, and we can see our little clip here. And I'm going to duplicate it for however many layers or nodes you have. So I am going to add 7, or add 6 for 7 total video layers here. Now I'm going to go in and create a little staircase. You'll have to play around with this based on your preference. Just know that the closer together the steps are, the faster those swipes and layers are going to happen. So again, typically if you're working on your film reel or demo reel, it's going to go a lot faster. But if you're doing like a tutorial, you want to let it hang for at least a couple seconds here. It doesn't have to be perfect. It won't be noticeable. So now obviously if I play back here, it all looks the same. It's the same clip duplicated. So next I'm going to head back to my color page, and I can see all of my clips down here at the bottom. And I'm going to select the first one. And then what I'm going to do is turn off all my nodes except for the first one, or all your layers. And you're now just going to turn them on one by one, selecting the next clip each time. So now on the second clip, I'm going to turn all off except the first two. And so on this. And I think you guys get the picture. All right, so now that we've done that, I'm gonna head back to the edit page. And if I play this through, you can see all the layers turning on one by one. Now here's where the swipe comes into play. I'm going to leave my first layer alone. And unless you wanna transition it in, you can, but I'm gonna leave it starting normal. And then I'm gonna go to my second layer here. And in Resolve, you have your crop tool on the right. Final Cut Premiere may be in a slightly different spot, but most likely it's in your inspector. And then you can choose any direction you'd like. Normally I go right to left. So what you want to do is make sure your playhead is at the beginning of the clip. And then I'm going to drag it all the way to the right, essentially turning off or hiding the clip entirely. I'm going to add a keyframe. And then I'm going to use my arrow keys or move the playhead about halfway through the stair step. And now I'm going to take it back all the way to the left. So now it reveals that layer. And you're going to repeat this process for the rest of the steps. Alrighty, so now that I've finished my final layer here, I'm going to play it back. And there you have it. Simple as that, but wait, there's a couple more things you can add. So again, this is kind of a medium pace. You can see each swipe. Now, the only weird part is some of them are definitely more noticeable than others. You can see in this one, as we add the vignette, we can see that very sharp vertical line. Same with the first couple of clips, just because there's such a drastic change. But then on the clip where it adds the beauty filter, it's pretty hard to tell. You can see it when you go frame by frame, but when you watch it, we can see that the creative LUT was added and the beauty one. And now this is the vignette. So just keep that in mind that if you want it to all look very drastic, again, if this is your demo reel, maybe you would combine the beauty filter on the same kind of swipe that you would do the creative LUT. You don't have to show literally each node if you don't want to. You can turn them on and off and combine clips. However, if you're not doing a demo reel and you really want to show each node and each point, this is where you can also go in and add titles for each one. So you could add a title layer for each. And this is where, again, it just a little bit of time. So now that you've added those in, you get fancy. You could do the same crop thing if you want, or you can just have them kind of pop up. Totally depends how much extra time you want to spend. But if you're doing like a tutorial, this can be really helpful. So people could actually pause and take a look as to what is going on in each layer. I'm going to hide this layer for now. Now, one more thing you could do, this I'm not sure is in any other program, but DaVinci Resolve and their crop tool, they have a very nice softness slider. So let's say you want to do this same effect, but you don't really care for the really harsh line. You could actually go in and completely soften it, go all the way to 100%. And if I do that for all of the clips, now if I play it through, so now instead of the harsh line, you have a much softer kind of feathered out stroke. So there you have it, guys. That is a super simple way to get that cool swiping effect for changing color. Obviously, you could adapt this same thing to pretty much anything, sort of graphic reveals or layer reveals. If you guys have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments down below. I'll always try to hop down there and answer anything you have. And don't forget to get subscribed and come back later this week for another Edit Place video. And I'll see you guys in the next video.